Welcome again to ASP.NET Core MVC tutorial. In this video, we will understand about the middleware in ASP.NET Core application. Middleware is the backbone and very important concept for any ASP.NET Core application. So you must learn about the middleware very carefully. Let's understand what all we will learn in this video. In this video, we will understand what is middleware, how middleware works, where is the middleware available inside our application, how to add new middleware, what is the order of middleware, and there are some methods use, next, and map. We will also understand what is the use of these three methods. Okay, now let's understand about the middleware in ASP.NET Core MVC application. Before learning about the middleware, let's understand how the request and response works in .NET Core MVC application. Here on the left side, I have a browser which is called client, and here on the right side, we have a server where we are using .NET Core MVC application. When you type a URL inside your browser, then a request from browser goes to the server and we got the response. Since we are using MVC architecture inside our application, so we generally assume that when we send a request from browser to server, it directly goes to the controller. Then all the processing happens on the controller and we got the response as a view on the browser. But before actually hitting to the controllers, the request has to pass through some components, and these components are known as HTTP pipeline or middlewares. So here at this place, you can see that before actually hitting to the controller, the request has to pass through these components. Now let's understand about the middleware in ASP.NET Core MVC. ASP.NET Core create an HTTP application pipeline that processes the request. In each ASP.NET Core MVC application, you will see there is a pipeline which is called HTTP application pipeline, and this HTTP application pipeline is responsible to handle all the requests and response for this particular application. This HTTP pipeline is configured in configure method of startup.cs. In every application, by default, we have a startup class, and inside that startup class, we have a method which is called as configure method, and all the components of HTTP pipeline are written in this configure method. All the requests to the application goes through the HTTP pipeline. Now, the middleware. A middleware is a piece of code, or we can say it is a software component which is used in HTTP pipeline. So HTTP pipeline is basically a combination of multiple middlewares. In an .NET Core application, we use multiple middlewares. Middleware has access to all the requests and responses. So generally, before actually hitting to the controller, we have a separate part, or we can say component, where we have defined lots of middlewares, and these middlewares has access to all the response and request which are made to this particular application. These middlewares are used to add several features to our application. Remember guys, since these middlewares has access to all the request and response, it means we can perform lots of things over here. For example, I want to implement logging into the application. To implement the logging into the application, we need to find out a centralized place where we can have access to all the request and response. And middleware is that place. So at the middleware place, you can define your logging. Because middleware has access to all the request and response, by using middleware, you can create your logs for each request and response. Another example is security, which is authentication and authorization. Suppose in my application, I have a controller which is a secure controller. What is the meaning of secure controller? It means I want to give the access of this controller to some specific users, where we can say only to the logged in users or only to those users who have a specific role. And suppose a request comes from the browser to this particular controller. Now, before actually sending this request to the controller, we need to validate this request, whether this is a valid request or not. And since middleware has access to all the request and response, so we can verify that request in the middleware whether it is valid or not. Here you can see we have a basic diagram of the middlewares in .NET Core application. As I already told you that in one application, we might have multiple middlewares. Okay, so here at this place, we are using three middlewares. Here you can see this one is first, then we have second, and we have the third. Okay, so we got a new request from browser, and then this request will actually hit the first middleware which is available in the pipeline. The order of the middleware matters a lot. First, it will hit to the first middleware. in the first middleware there will be some logic, then that logic will be performed, and then to go to the next middleware we have to call the next method. So if the next method is written into the first middleware, then the request will go to the second middleware. If the next method is not written in the first middleware, then the request will be completed and we will get the response onto the client. But if we have written next in the first middleware, then the request will travel from first middleware to the second middleware, and obviously there will be some logic in the second middleware as well, then that logic will be completed. And similarly, if we have the next method, then the request will go to the next third middleware and so on. You can define n number of middlewares in your application as per the requirement, and once all the middleware logic will be completed, then we will get the response. And in the same manner that you were handling the request, the response will be handled. First it will come from 3 to 2 and then 2 to 1. So this is how the basic flow of the middleware works in ASP.NET Core MVC application. Let's understand all these things in practical scenario. So here I am using the same application that we have created for the bookstore, and here you can see we have few files. First we have startup file and we have the program file. Let's click on the program file first. In the program file you can see we have a main method and we have a web host builder. So here you can see we have the web host builder, and this web host builder is using startup file. Let's click on the startup file. Inside this startup file you can see we have two methods. First one is configure services and then we have configure. Let's see the default comment on this method, which is this method gets called by the runtime. Use this method to configure the HTTP request pipeline. So here inside this method we can configure our request pipeline. Inside this method you can see that already some of the code is written over here. So here you can see this one is one code, then the second code, and then the third piece of code. Okay, so for now let's comment all these things and let's create a new middleware inside this pipeline. Remember, every request which is coming to this application will come here at this place. Then all the middlewares that we will write over here, the request will pass through those components or middlewares, and then the response will be generated. To create a new middleware we can use app. To create a custom middleware we can use the use method. Okay, let's understand the detail of this use method. Let's right click on it and go to the definition. So this method is available inside iApplication Builder interface. Let's click on this Eclipse. Adds a middleware delegate to the application's request pipeline. So this use method is used to add a new middleware inside the request pipeline application. Okay, yes. So now we have to pass the parameters, and since ASP.NET Core works on async programming, so we have to type here async. Let's put the semicolon. Okay, and then we have to write some message so that we can get some message on the console. We are creating the response over here. So context dot response dot write async. So here I can write a message, hello from my first middleware, and that's it. There is nothing inside this application. We have only one middleware, which is app.use, and this method is used to simply write a message onto the response. Let's run this application now. Here you can see we have our output, hello from my first middleware. Okay, fine. Now let's add one more middleware to this application. And to add one more middleware, I can simply copy this code and then I can paste it over here. Let's change the message from second and let's run the application. At this point you can see we got the message. And what is the message? Hello from my first middleware. Why we are getting only the message from first middleware? Why not the second message is not displayed over here? To understand this, why the second middleware message is not displayed over here, let's go back to our previous slide. So here you can see we have all the middlewares. So suppose this is my first middleware and this is my second middleware. I already told you that we must call next method if we want to send the request from first middleware to the second middleware. So since we have not used next method by now, that is why we are not getting any message from the second middleware. It means the request is coming to the first middleware, and from this middleware we are getting the response. The request is not going to the second middleware. And now let's call the next method. Cool. Now let's see what will happen. Let's run the application again. Okay, so you can see now we got two messages. First we have hello from my first middleware, and then we have hello from my second middleware. Since we have used next method, it means both the middlewares are working fine for this particular request. So after calling the next method, I want to display one more message, and I can simply copy it over here and paste it. I can write response. Now let's press Ctrl F5. Now guys, simply understand the logic. First we have message hello from my first middleware, fine. Then we have second message hello from my second middleware. Okay, so the first request comes to the first middleware, then it is passing to the second middleware, and once the logic of the second middleware is completed, then it goes back to the first middleware. That is why we are getting this third message over here, which is hello from my first middleware response. And I already told you that we can insert n number of middlewares in our application. So at this place you can insert n number of middlewares. Let's verify that also. So we can copy this code from here and I can paste it in the second middleware. Let's update the message. Okay, cool. And let's add one more middleware to the application. So let's copy the entire code and paste it again. Let's close this output window. So now you can see we have three middleware. This is the first, second, and third. We do not have any further middleware, so I can remove this code. Okay. And now let's run the application. Let's see the order of these messages. First we have hello from my first middleware. Fine. Then we have hello from my second middleware. Cool. Then we have hello from my third middleware. Since we are using next method in both the middlewares, that is why we are getting all these methods in order. And now at this place, the request is at the third middleware. So what will happen now? From the third, it will go to the second middleware. So we must have the message from hello from my second middleware response. And once the logic of the second middleware will be completed, then the request will travel back to the first middleware. So that is why we have hello from my first middleware response. Fine. Now let's understand few more logics, and for that let's uncomment this code. Okay, so all these are middlewares. This is also a middleware, this one is also a middleware, this one is also a middleware, this is also a middleware, this one as well, and then this one as well. Okay, now let's run the application. Let's press Ctrl F5. Just focus on the output of this application. At the last we have first middleware response. Okay, let's go back to the code. Here in this code we have hello world message. Do we have hello world anywhere on the output? No, we do not have hello world anywhere on the output, because we are not using next method inside this third middleware. I already told you that the order of middleware matters a lot. The order is from top to bottom. So the first request will come here. First this one will be executed, then this one, then this one, and here we have not written next. That is why these middlewares will not be considered in the HTTP pipeline application. To call this one, we have to call the next method. And since this is async, so we have to use await. Now let's press F5. Here you can see we have the hello world message. So it means all of these are working fine. Let's understand a few more concepts, and let's remove these three middlewares from this application. Now we have only the default code. So we have use routing middleware and use endpoints middleware. Okay, what is the use of these two middlewares? Routing is basically to map the URL to a particular resource, and here we are mapping the URL to a particular resource. Here you can see in the endpoints we have map get method. Map get is mapping a particular URL to a particular resource. Here is the URL. So this is the default URL. It means only the domain. There should not be anything after the domain. If there is only the domain in the browser, then this response will be returned to the output. Instead of using map get, we can only use map method also. This map method will also map this particular route to this particular resource. But what is the difference in between map and map get? Map get will only handle only the get request which are coming for this particular route. and the map will handle all the requests which are coming to this particular route. So that is why mapget was written by default over there. Now if I use one more middleware and let's write it like this, and instead of using this by default, I would like to write a custom route, and I want to write it Nitish, and here I want to write the new message Nitish. Okay, let's run the application now. Here you can see we have only the domain in the URL of this browser, so it means it is mapping to this piece of code. So that is why we are getting this message hello world. If I type Nitish in the URL, now you can see we have the second output, which is hello Nitish, and this output is coming from here. So by using the map method, you can map your route to a particular resource. To understand one more concept, let's comment this use route middleware. Now we have not enabled the routing in the application and still we are using these routes. Now let's see what will happen. Let's press F5. So we got the error: endpoint routing middleware matches endpoint setup by endpoints middleware and so must be added to the request execution pipeline before endpoints middleware. So before using this endpoints, we must use routing in this application. Let's continue. So we got the error again here, and here we got the error page on the browser. From this error, we must understand that inserting a piece of component or middleware is very much important into the HTTP pipeline, and the order of the middleware also matters a lot. What will happen if I use this route middleware from this place to this place? So first we are using these endpoints and then we are using the routing. Let's press F5 again. So again we got the same error, because in the order of the middlewares, we have not defined routing before using the actual routes. That is why we are getting this error. What is happening? We are using the routes, but we are defining the routing after using these routes. So the order of the middlewares must be in a proper way. That is why we are getting this error. Let's stop this application. And if I use this app.routing on the previous place, then everything will work as it was working fine. So we have the default message, and if I change the route, then we got the second message. In this entire tutorial, we will be using lots of middlewares. So we will use all those middlewares whenever they will be required. So for now, let's remove all the things which we have made in this code. That is all in this video. I hope after watching this video, you must have a good idea of middleware in ASP.NET Core application. Middleware is the backbone of any ASP.NET Core application. Lots of logics and features are written in the middleware, which makes an application to a complete or perfect ASP.NET Core application. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.